While everyone is waiting desperately for Copilot to be released, what we don't realize is something similar has been there in Excel for years. You go to Excel, Home tab, and you should see Analyze Data or Ideas here. This requires an Office 365 version of Excel. If you don't see that button, go to File, Account, and it should say Microsoft 365 Apps for Enterprise. Otherwise, you have some kind of desktop version, and it's not going to have that AI-based feature. I have some data here, 8 columns, 1,500 rows. Now, the question is, if this is the raw data, who decides how many reports to create? Generally, the answer I get is boss decides. So let's see what exactly analytics means. We already have data. That means it has already happened. It's historical or past. So we are looking at the past data and trying to learn. Learn what? Oh, something useful, of course. And then once you learn something, you're going to use that knowledge to improve something, do something which will make the future more favorable for you. That's the whole concept of the analytics cycle. Now the question, learn how many useful things? And then the answer is whatever number, 7, 8, 9, 10, basically few. And that's the problem. Logically, how many things would you like to learn? As many things as possible, because how many useful things? You'll never know. Let's change this. I want to learn all possible things. I want to be greedy, because the more I know, better I'll manage my life, my business, my work, my domain. Good. So now how do you implement this? That's the question. And the answer is AI, and it has already been done at least for 4 or 5 years. So now all that you have to do is, yes, click on the raw data and click on this button. If your Office version is not updated, it will be called Ideas button. Now it does not ask you any question. It doesn't ask you how many reports you want. It shows you the reports you should be looking at. Because if you wait for someone to ask for a report and then produce it, there is a chance that there is something very important, but nobody is asking for it. So nobody is looking for it. Nobody is creating the report. Nobody is acting on it. That's loss of opportunity. Now what is happening here? Because this data is being automatically analyzed, every column correlated with every other column statistically using an AI algorithm, and whatever the algorithm thinks is important or statistically significant is being shown to you on a platter. So the bare minimum you should be doing is look at that platter. You need not taste it. Just look at it. Do you know this already? Fine. Go. Probably amount by month is a report you already created. Okay, move on. Maybe this one. Have you seen this one? This is an outlier report. Because I never look at my data at daily level of analysis. That's too much of detail. I generally summarize it by whatever, month, quarter, year, and then you will not see those spikes. Maybe you miss this, but that's your opportunity. Now also notice the show more button. Click on it. It is showing you more. So this is a type of report is called outliers. This is a ranking report, and it shows you in the descending order who is bigger and smaller. This is a majority report. This is shown when one item is way bigger than everyone else. So not only is it first rank, second rank is very small. So this is called majority. And there's a scatter chart which shows you two variables which are numeric. In this case, age and amount. Again, you can see two outliers here. It also shows you trends, shows you frequency distribution. Now look at this report. Whatever product I'm selling, I don't know the exact age here, but this is younger age, this is older age. So people in older age group are not buying your product or whatever it is. So that's something which can be very useful input from the point of view of planning, marketing, product design, whatever. Now, here is the deal. Frequency of amount means small amount versus large amount. Most of your transactions seem to be very small. Now, that may be another thing which you may not have consciously noticed. All this is great, but what if I want to investigate something further? Good question. For example, I want to know which are these outliers. I'm not getting any data, so click on this. It's either insert pivot chart or pivot table, depending on what kind of visual it is. So I'm going to click on pivot chart. It will add a new sheet. Of course, pivot chart requires a pivot table. So that's also there. It's formatted the chart. And now you can actually go and look at, oh, on this date, something wrong or abnormal happened, and then investigate it further. Is that great? What else can it do? Oh, well, it has natural language query, which is what we are raving about in ChatGPT. You just ask in your language and it does the job. That's exactly what this is doing. So look at the data. These questions, sample questions, have been created based on your data. What more do you want? So it's so dumbed down that in case you don't know how to ask a question, Microsoft is telling you, these are your questions, use them. Now the question you have to ask yourself is, do you find these questions interesting? And do you know the answer to them? Or knowing the answer will be useful. Oh, percentage distribution of expense type. Very good. Nice. So 29% of my business happens online. Maybe I didn't know that with such clarity. Good. Because I get a pivot table. Now it also gives you other variations and so on. Notice percent of total amount by expense type. This is count, and see the beauty. Now, you need not be limited to these. You can ask your own questions. For example, I want to say top three city by average age. Now, please note, the word city is not there anywhere in my data. But it understood that the column LOC does have city names. How intelligent is that? Of course, for this to work, your data has to be clean. It should be tabular. Now, exactly what is clean data? That itself is a confusing thing. I have actually created a video which gives you 10 checklist items which you apply to your data and you know, is it clean? And if not, which part of it is not clean? And of course, you can then clean it up using Power Query. So have a look at that as well. Another thing you must notice in analyze data is this wheel. Very often we may have some columns which you don't want to analyze. Maybe there is a column called ID, product ID, which you don't want to analyze at all because product name is there. So you can unselect a particular column you may not want. In this case, I want all the columns, but there is another one. Year, for example, is a number, but you don't want to be treated as a number. So there is a thing called not a value, or you want to do it as sum or average. Now notice I did not come here and change anything, but it has intelligently picked up the correct settings. In case it has not, you can customize them. In this case, year is not being treated as a value. Amount is being summed by default, and age is considered as average. You already have this. So what is the best practice you have to think of? Everyone in my company has this button, but how many of them are clicking on that button? That's the important thing. Please create an SOP or standard operating procedure which says, whenever you finish creating standard regular reports in Excel, don't stop. Go to the raw data and then click on the analyze data or ideas button, eyeball it and take action. So that is how AI in Excel can be used right now. I'm sure you found this useful. So you know what to do. Like, share, subscribe. Bell icon, thanks button also. I have another video which covers AI in Excel and Power BI. Have a look at that as well. That's it for now. Thank you.